Shalom. This is Bishop Nathaniel of Israel United in Christ. I want to start off by saying thank you to all of our Booster Club members for your many donations and much more, your prayers. We've visited faraway countries and strange lands. We've even spoken to dignitaries and were detained for spreading the glorious gospel in Cuba. The truth is that the descendants of the 12 tribes of Israel were scattered throughout the world. Help us on our journey as we continue to raise up the nation of Israel. 12 tribes worldwide. Join or donate today. Shalom.
We are not out here to perpetuate the cycle of hatred. Give me Matthew 19, because the brother was asking, how do you get to the kingdom of heaven?
Right.
That's a very vital question. At the end of the day, we want to know how to get there. The pastor told us all we got to do is be saved. But what does that entail? What does being saved entail, brother? What does it mean to be saved? We're trying to show our people how to get to the kingdom of heaven, and nobody wants to come forth and learn how to get to the kingdom of heaven. They drive by and scoff. We teaching out of the Bible because we've studied the Bible.
That's right.
We ain't coming out here teaching out of our emotions. We're not coming out here teaching out of what somebody told us.
Right.
We're coming teaching in the spirit of Christ, in the spirit of the Lord. You want to know how to wake up out of the conditions we're in? Well, come and talk to the prophets.
Teach.
I'm not talking smooth. I'm not talking sweet, because y'all in a burning building.
Bring it out.
Y'all got to be told that this society is not going to last. It's not going to last. It's not time to play with y'all out here.
Right.
That's not what we about.
Right.
We've been dying too long out here.
Right.
Our people lost and crazy in the brain.
Bring it up.
How do we get to the kingdom of heaven?
I just want to ask one.
Read
the book of Matthew, chapter 19 and verse 16. And behold, one came and said unto him, good master, what good thing shall I do that I may have eternal life?
We're talking about eternal life. The soldier, when he came down, he was talking about who the gates of heaven is for.
Right.
The gates of heaven are for the 12 tribes of the nation of Israel.
Yes.
There are 12 gates to the kingdom of heaven. There's not this one big pearly gate that you've been made to believe in. Brother, my brother, stand up. You got a question, right?
Yeah.
Right. Listen at this.
I was reading last.
Listen at this. The Bible said, how do we get to the kingdom of heaven? This brother approached Christ. He called him good master. He said, what good thing must I do to get the kingdom of heaven? That's the question all us asking. How do we get to heaven? Right? Read.
And he said unto him, why callest thou me good?
The first thing Christ did, he led an example. Right? It's taught to us that we're supposed to follow Christ's example. His example was, why you calling me good? I ain't no better than none of y'all.
Right.
I just know a little something different than y'all know.
Right.
I know what my Father's will is.
Right.
That don't make me better than you, because I'm standing here.
Right.
It don't make me better. It just make me knowing this truth before you knew the truth. That's all it makes. Don't call me good. There's only one good. All right? Don't let no man fool you. On this earth, too many men been fooling too many men, making them think that they're good and trustworthy. There's only one good. Read.
There is none good but one. That is God.
You hear that? That's what we stand on. We stand on God being good.
That's
we understand
right.
That men is twisted in their brain.
Right.
You understand that? God is good. That's the example we follow. Read.
But if thou wilt enter into life.
I'm going to answer your question, though, but if you want to enter into the kingdom of heaven. Read.
Keep the commandments.
Be saved.
Keep the commandments.
I'm going regardless.
Keep the commandments.
You have to do what to get to the kingdom of heaven, my brother?
To be saved.
be saved? You say be saved. What you have to do to get to the kingdom of heaven, according to what we just read?
No.
What do we have to do, my brother?
No.
My brother, right in front of me with your arms folded. What do we have to do to get to the kingdom of heaven? You know what we have to do to get to the kingdom of heaven? We're going to read it one more time. Read.
Keep the commandments.
You hear that? You got to keep the commandments.
That's right.
That's the law. What law? Which law?
God's law.
God's. Let's read.
God's law.
And he said that to him, which? Jesus said, there's
which? Which commandments must we keep? Read.
Thou shalt do no murder.
You hear that? In order to get to the kingdom of heaven, the Lord Jesus Christ is quoting Moses. He said, thou shalt not commit murder. You ain't gotta literally stab somebody. You ain't gotta literally shoot somebody. You ain't gotta literally poison somebody to kill them. You can be in a spirit of hatred, my brother, my sisters, and be in the sin of murder.
Right.
Hatred is murder. Give me John 3:15. Hatred is murder.
Right.
Do no murder. What we doing out here right now is we saving y'all lives. We showing y'all how to get to the kingdom of heaven. Let's read.
The book of John, chapter 3:15.
Bring it out.
Whosoever hateth his brother is a murderer.
You hear that? You hate your brother, you are a murderer.
Right.
Read.
And ye know that no murderer hath eternal life abiding in him.
Hatred for your brother. You pull up, you don't understand what it is we preaching. You don't understand what it is we teaching.
Right.
But you screaming at the top of your lungs with hatred for your brothers who trying to save they brothers. The Lord said you got hatred and you will not get the kingdom of heaven.
Yes, right.
Regardless of what punishment you've been through. We've been through punishments as people. Why? So we can come back to the understanding of who we are. He said it in their affliction, they will seek him early.
Right, bring it out.
God got to punish us.
Right.
Because we don't know everything's bad until everything is all bad.
That's right.
We think we got a little job and everything is all good.
Jeez.
We think we're riding in a nice car and everything is all good. We think because we sleeping from baby mama to baby mama, everything is all good.
Bring it out.
But when the Lord start afflicting you, he'll start afflicting your pockets. He start afflicting your memory. He start afflicting your health. He start afflicting those around you that you so-called love. Then you'll start questioning like, man, what's wrong?
Teacher.
Something ain't right.
Right.
Bring it out.
I thought we was in an advanced society.
Right.
Why is my people dying and nobody getting recompense for it? 80% unsolved murder rates in Chicago.
Bring it out.
They don't care to solve the crimes. They won't try to kill each other.
Bring it out.
Police officers get a snap on the wrist for killing y'all. They get incentives for killing y'all.
Bring it out.
They get desk jobs for killing y'all. They get paid leave for killing y'all. They get GoFundMe set up for killing y'all.
Bring it out.
They go to jail for a day and go down to Florida and go away and change their name and disappear for killing y'all.
Bring it out.
Why is that? Because the Lord got to afflict you to wake you up to show you that this ain't your rest.
That's right.
Hosea 5:15.
Bring it out.
I will go and return to my place till they acknowledge their offense.
The Israelites have to acknowledge their offense. The Lord our God said he's going to turn his back on us. All these things shall happen to us. You shall be gunned down and die in the street like men.
That's right.
You shall receive STDs. You shall receive hatred until you recognize your offense.
That's right.
Answer me this. How can you know your offense if you don't know the guidelines in which you should be walking by?
Bring it out.
Nobody's ever told you the guidelines you should be walking by so you can gauge whether or not you're in offense.
Bring it out.
We're going to bring it out. Read.
And seek my face.
We gotta seek the Lord's face. We can't be seeking the dollar. The dollar ain't gonna save you. Economics ain't gonna save you.
Right.
These several men with their ideologies ain't gonna save you.
Right.
The white man is not gonna save you.
Right.
The Lord says, seek my face. Read.
In their affliction, they will seek me early.
What we do when we catch a hell, read.
They will seek me early.
We marching down the street, wondering what's going on. Why is our people being oppressed? Who are we seeking?
They will seek me early.
We always crying out to God when things go wrong, sister. My brother, my brothers. Listen, when things go wrong, what do our people normally do? oh God, why me? And that's it. That's as far as they seek him. But you're supposed to seek him further. Why you think we out here? He sent us out here. He put the spirit on us to tell y'all, come back. You living, you still breathing. Why? Because you still got an opportunity to come back. But don't take this grace lightly, because it's not going to last forever. Fire is destined to come to this place. You are not going to be walking around doing the same old thing. Destroying your temple, getting high. Disrespecting your women, not marrying them. Hating your kids, not teaching them. You're not going to be doing that forever.
That's right.
Come back to God. Seek his
We used to scream black power while Heron was pushed. But at the end of the day, nothing's in vain. IUIC has been given a vision. The tents of Judah has risen. Many has attempted the mission. Minor murmuring, omitting, and missing the mark. Just reading that he had the flame of fire in his eyes gave us the spark. We on Paul's mission. We out on the road. Purple and gold. From Mexico, Cuba, Haiti, Ghana, Sierra Leone. 144,000 boots banging, concrete crackling. These are how our men repented at heart. The scriptures is proof. IUIC, we deliver the truth.